140 years since the Battle of Trafalgar, but in Trafalgar Square in London, that great day is still remembered on its anniversary. It is remembered throughout the British Empire. It is remembered in the Royal Navy. And it is remembered by the navies of our enemies, because the spirit of Trafalgar lives on. The first great naval victory of this war was the Craf Spee, sunk off Montevideo. How many times has the Ark Royal been sunk in theory? Only she fights on in reality. Italy's Navy has cause to remember the date of the battering of her ships in Taranto Bay by the planes of the fleet air arm. The proudest ship in all the German fleet was the Bismarck, but the Bismarck sails no more. Enemy bases have also felt the weight of naval salvos. But the greatest victory pales into insignificance today beside the endless vigil that the Navy keeps guarding our lanes of commerce. At one time in this war, two and three ships were being sunk each day. Since then, our losses have been cut and cut again. Our cameraman has been out with a unit in the Mediterranean. At one point, a large batch of German and Italian naval prisoners were taken on board. Unwilling witnesses of the Navy's triumphs. When the Navy sweeps the sea, it certainly does clean up a lot of rubbish. And you'll be glad to see they make them work. Here's the dear old Ark Royal. Wherever she goes, she finds trouble. And in this attack by Italian bombers and torpedo planes, the enemy paid heavily. AK-AK guns and fighters accounted for 14 of the raiders. Away in the distance, two Italian planes are being shot down. And the Navy keeps the score. After that action, news was received that Italian warships were at sea and the fleet went all out to get them. But once again, Mussolini's landlocked Navy scurried back to port before it could be brought to action. Every hour of the day and night, our sailors are fighting a battle that has been raging for over 2 years. And our ships still find their crews in the men of the Nelson breed.